store tracker boat with an 80 cent purchase for $500 or more.
Do it.
He said, I'm trying to go dumb on him. I was like, this man just said that on.
You want to hear me, girl?
So he backed out. He's just going, he's going to do a taper.
No,
he ain't. Yeah, bro.
What a coward.
It's too long, bro.
Right, you got to try?
In the car at the moment. I had to get a little taper, though.
What's up, loco? You had to do something? Hey, just do this right here.
No.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just a young player trying to get ahead.
It took a long time to grow this. What you mean? Like a year and 2-3 months.
Don't tell me you're rethinking, bro. You want to cut it?
You got time?
Yeah, man.
Hey, should he cut his hair off?
Do it!
Don't even think about it. Man, give him the shears, man. Let him cut it off himself. I like it right now. Give him the. No, 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 no. Let him cut it himself. I look like crusty the clown right now. Comment below if he should cut this all off. Don't worry, guys. He's a barber. I said it. You sure you want to do this?
You want to do it?
Number three. He wants to cut it all off.
The whole thing?
Don't worry, guys. He's a barber.
I said it.
Yeah, he did it.
What? Oh my God. All right, take this. That's a whole year. Made me look beautiful.
Oh, man. They sound really cool. Hey, Portland had you pulling your hair out last night anyway. You see that grandma put it all off.
Damn, Portland.
This is a thumbnail right here, bro. Ain't no going back now, bruh.
Leave it like that.
Like this?
Leave it like that.
Yes, it's time for this major transformation, man. We are taking the number three guard against the grain. All the way around his head. Make sure we get it as even as possible. We shampooed his hair. I didn't add that in the video, but we shampooed it. Because if you know you grow your hair out this long, you're gonna have some cowlicks, you're gonna have some hair, you know, trying to grow a certain way, comb a certain way. As you can tell, looks like he has a head full of cowlicks. So after, you know, cutting such long hair off, you definitely wanna shampoo the hair. Right here, I'm just showing y'all that how his hair is growing in different types of directions because it was so long. And now we gotta train it back. That way we can start combing it forward again. We're gonna do a mid to high ball fade. Keep the number three up top. Add a little bit of color enhancement on the lineup. But we are gonna bring my boy back to life. As you can tell, he had a
year
and some months of hair.
What happened?
Y'all put extra air in the ball.
Transformation, and he's starting to get into some real estate, so he just wants to be taken a little more serious, right? I'm not saying that a haircut doesn't mean that you're not serious, but he just wants people to start running, right? You want to look a certain part. So he decided to cut it all off, get a number three against the grain, and do a ball fade. Right here, I just added some hair tonic to the scalp. But after that, I went ahead and washed his hair anyway because I saw how it was laying. So at this point, I had already washed and shampooed his hair and conditioned it. So now all his hair is laying down. It's not, you know, swirled up or nothing like that. And I want to keep this guideline pretty low because I want to give myself room to blend. His hair is super tricky to fade. It's light and kind of like open to certain spots as far as like the hair follicles. It's just, you got to be very careful whenever you cut his hair because there's a lot of open spots. As you can tell on his head, like there's light spots everywhere. So his haircut is pretty difficult to do. Started with the lever all the way open with my Gamma Ergos. And after I started with the lever open, I completely closed the lever and started working my way to the dark line. So after I closed the lever and started working out that bottom line, I put it in the middle and then I opened it up just a little bit more before it opened all the way and just removed that line completely. Wherever that dark line is at, we're gonna take number one guard all the way open and create our next panel. But always knock out this bottom panel first, open, middle, close, or even close, middle, open, just depending on how I feel. And then right here, this is number one guard, open. Again, I gave myself room to blend, so now I'm able to have, you know, about an inch per guideline to kind of spread that blend and have some nice gradiency from light, middle, you know, medium to dark. After I did the one open, I put the lever in the middle, started, you know, softening up that line that the one left behind open, and then I put the lever closed all the way, which is now one, which I'm doing now, and you could tell that line is getting erased a little bit. It's not going to get removed all the way because you'll have to come back with your half guard or your zero guard, but before I do that, I always like to jump to a number two guard. Now the reason why I jumped to a two guard before a one and a half guard, in my opinion, I feel like it allows me to keep that mid area of the blend darker than normal. After I take the two open, there is a number three against the grain on top, so the two open is gonna blend right into whatever the three is on top. After I've had the lever all the way open, I'll put it in the middle, like I said, and then close it. And then I'll come back with the one and a half guard and start to blend out whatever the two close left behind. Then we'll come back down and we'll remove that bottom line with the zero guard or a half guard, depending on what system you're using. But you can tell, man, like I'm having some difficulties, you know, blending his hair and just cutting it in certain directions and trying to feed that hair into the guard because his hair is just growing in all different types of directions right now. So you want to make sure you feed that hair into the guard, that way the fade looks proportionate all the way through. It doesn't look like there's dark areas, you know, around his head or behind his head. You want to make sure that's pretty even. And as you can tell, that blend is coming together. Now we have the number one guard open. This is a different one guard than the black guard that I had that came with this clipper. For some reason, I like to, you know, go in between this one guard and also my half guard that I have for my walls after I use the one guard with the ergos, and after I use a zero guard that comes with the ergos as well. I like to use my half guard that comes with the wall. I might be double working myself, but for some reason I just feel like there's some in-betweens in there. Right here, this is the zero guard that the Ergo Clippers came with. So I always start with the lever open, put it in the middle, close it, and that'll remove that bottom line. Now, like I said, I just feel like the half guard that comes with the wall cuts just a little bit closer. So I like to follow that through after I use this zero guard that this clipper came with. I like to follow it up with the half guard, as so right here. So this is the wall premium half guard. This is just me detailing my work, bringing everything together. You may not see what I'm seeing because obviously I'm cutting this hair in person. You're looking at the camera screen. So any little dark spots or little details that I can use that half guard to brush up just to have that nice contrast, man. I like to double dip the zero guard in my half guard. That's just me. It's a system that I like, system that I enjoy doing. I don't feel like I'm overworking myself or whatever. Some barbers don't even use half guards, but it's just a system that works for me, so I stick with it. The reason why I said mid to high fade is because I'm giving myself room to blend. I'm actually spreading that actual blend. He wanted a high fade, but I know how my blends come out and how I want to start them and give myself room to blend and have a stretched fade. I think the stretched fade looks that much better versus a compressed blend. But again, that's my opinion. I think that fade is coming together. And I'm just working areas that I feel like are darker than others. You may not see it, but I see it, in person. So that's just me doing some light detail work. I'm going to let y'all enjoy the other side. Enjoy this dope beat by my boy Apollo Beats. If you are interested in any type of beats, man, any of my videos, all the dope beats that I have on there, make sure you look at the Instagram handle in the description below. It's Apollo. Dude is a dope producer, man. I appreciate the opportunity to allow me to have these beats on my channel, man. Keep grinding, keep making music, and keep, providing me with those beats to have dope content and a nice vibe along with the videos, bro. Appreciate you. Y'all go ahead and enjoy the same steps as you do to the other side. Thank you. Alright, so right here I had already sprayed a little bit of hairspray to kind of hold those hair into place. Y'all may not know this, but now I'm gonna let you know. My man has SMP on his hairline. If y'all don't know what that is, it's scalp micropigmentation. Basically darkening those light areas that he has in his front lineup. So I'm gonna keep it as natural as possible. He does have S&P around that vertical bar area, so we're not gonna go against it. We're not gonna go further than what I'm doing now. I'm just following the lineup that he has with the S&P. I'm gonna add a little bit of a C-cup in there just to add to that blend. But other than that, guys, we're not gonna do anything crazy to his edge up. We're gonna follow it, the natural lineup, and obviously the lineup that he has with the S&P. If y'all are not familiar with S&P and y'all want to get educated on it, look it up on Instagram. My boy Jesse Lima in the Brandon, Tampa area is a beast. He teaches his students, like, man, like the work that he does. I refer my clients that are, you know, have light spots or are balding or receding. I refer my clients to him all the time. He does amazing work. He's an amazing teacher as well. So make sure you hit up Jesse Lima on Instagram at 6ElementSMP. But just follow him on Instagram, Jesse Lima, if y'all are interested in scalp micropigmentation. Definitely a way to get rid of that receding hairline, balding, light areas in your beard, anything like that. Make sure you hit him up. I don't know if Jesse did his S&P or a student of Jesse Lima did his S&P, but they did an amazing job, and that's what I'm following right now. Give me a dope outline. But as you can tell, man, my man has been brought to life. I'm adding that color enhancement on there, that 245 No Drip Onyx, that black, and I'm just filling in those little light areas that are spread apart, and I'm not fixing nothing. I'm enhancing the haircut. But I brought my boy back to life, man. Loco, I'm sorry, bro, but you needed me in your life. Now, it's dope always chopping it up with him. And, you know, we both got kids, wives, we got busy lives. So he works at another barbershop, Headlines. But, you know, he works at another location, so we barely even talk. But, bro, I hope you enjoyed this haircut, man, as much as I enjoyed doing this transformation. Thank you for allowing me to have the opportunity to do this transformation for you, bro. It's all love. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, like, share, and comment if you love this transformation, this cut is clean. Man, and as always, keep gifted. Stay gifted. Oh, yeah, by the way, don't matter, bro. BLM all day.